JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 7th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD. I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advisory or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against most of the other major currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It lost ground against AUD, JPY, CHF and CAD in that order, while it gained only versus the euro and the British pound. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the kiwi. Now, the simultaneous weakening of the safe haven and risk-linked currencies paints a confusing picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, and therefore, in order to clear things up, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Their major European indices traded in the red, but later, all three of Wall Street's main indices closed in positive waters. The recovery in investors' morale rolled over into the Asian session today as well. It seems that the European shares took the torch from the Asian ones on Wednesday, which slid after the RBNZ hiked interest rates and signaled that more is very likely to come, reminding market participants that other major central banks may also tighten their respective policies faster than previously thought. That said, risk appetite improved during the US session after Senate's top Republican, Mitch McConnell, said his party would support an extension of the federal debt ceiling into December. Although this has far from diminished the chances of a government shutdown, it is the first sign of compromise in the latest standoff between Democratic and Republican lawmakers over the matter. Now, without any action, the Treasury Department has forecast that it will run out of ways to meet all its obligations by October 18th. Something that could result in delayed salaries for millions of federal employees, as well as delayed unemployment insurance and medical payments. Still, the matter may need to be addressed again in December, and therefore, even if equities trade higher for a while more, we are reluctant to call for a positive switch in the broader outlook. The other fundamental themes that have pushed equities lower recently remain well on the table as well. Those are fears over the impact of Evergrande's potential default to the global economy, as well as concerns over persistently high inflation, which could lead to faster than previously thought tightening by major central banks. What may have also helped equities to rebound may be the pullback in oil and gas prices after Russian leaders indicated that supply to Europe could increase. However, with only talks and no concrete action yet, and with energy prices staying in steep uptrends, we believe that market participants may stay concerned over high energy prices translating into further acceleration in inflation. Therefore, we stick to our guns that the path of least resistance for stock indices may still be to the downside, and that the recovery late yesterday and overnight may just be a corrective bounce. At the same time, we do see the case for the US dollar to continue trending north, especially if tomorrow's NFPs add extra credence to the case of a November tapering by the FOMC. Now, as for today's events, during the European session, we get the minutes from the latest ECB monetary policy meeting. At that meeting, the bank announced a moderately lower pace of PEP purchases for the following quarter, but President Lagarde made it clear that this was not a tapering move and that when PEP is over, they have all other tools available. In our view, this may be a hint that when PEP is over, conditional upon the economic outlook, they could compensate by buying more through other schemes, like the asset purchase program. So we will scan the minutes to see whether this is the case, and clear hints that the bank stands ready to offset the end of the PEP by buying more through other programs could encourage more euro selling. So in other words, we stay negative on the euro, especially against the US dollar, due to expectations that the Fed may start tapering QE in November. Now, later in the day, the US initial jobless claims for last week are due to be released, and expectations are for a small decline to 348,000 from 362,000. Canada's IV PMI for September is also coming out, but no forecast is available. As for the speakers, we will get to hear from ECB executive board members Frank Elderson, Philip Lane, and Isabel Schnabel, as well as by Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.